We've set up our preferences such as they are, and we can go back, change things anytime we want to. Let's take a look at the bridge interface, you know, what we can do. Before we go there, I'm going to show you something, share a secret with you, if you will. All programs have preferences. Preferences are saved in a file that basically says, here they are, change to this. That file can become corrupted. It's rare. Now, when that happens, all kinds of fun things happen. Your systems crash on you. They're slow. They're not doing what you want them to do. Now, compound that with Bridge that also has things like a cache with thousands of images that might go bad. I had an experience with Bridge, so this is actually my own living experience here, where the cache, apparently, was so corrupted, I couldn't even open Bridge. It crashed before it would open, so I couldn't even open it to fix the problem. Well, Adobe's got our back on this. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, Bridge, Premiere Pro, it doesn't matter. If you hold down three secret keys when you launch the program, you get the ability to purge all that stuff and start from scratch. Let's do this. Let me go up to the word file on the pull-down menu, and let's go down to Browse and Bridge. But before I click Browse and Bridge, I'm going to hold down three keys. You're on a Windows system? Control, Alt, Shift. You're on a Mac? Command, Option, Shift. Same keys, different names. Now here's the deal. You launch, then you hold. You got to be quick. So I'm hovering with one hand over those three keys. Now I'm going to click, hold. And you get this. What do you want to reset? Preferences, you want to purge the whole cache. I had to do that. And reset your standard workspaces. You're pulling the program as if it's brand new, you never used it. I'm going to click cancel, obviously. And that will take us into Bridge. Remember, you have that if you're experiencing problems. Now let's look at what we have. We have a content area here where we can click and select an image, obviously, or more than one. And when we do, we get a preview over here. If you get in this area and click your mouse, you get a nice little magnifying loop. And you can loop around or you can click it again to turn it off. If you select more than one, well, it'll show you more than one over there and you still get the loop if you want to use it. So we can do that. Let's start up here though. You have backward and forward buttons in your history as how you've been working. You have a breadcrumb trail right here where you can click to go back to any one of those if you want to. If you click this button right here, little down arrow, you can see things where you're working and you can see the folders that you're using and your favorites. If you click this button, I like this one, it reveals all your recent files and they divide them, Illustrator, InDesign, Photoshop, it's kind of nice. Recent folders, clear them if you want to. Over here, we have a boomerang, and that takes us back to Photoshop without anything. Just opens Photoshop for us. This button allows us to bring images in from a camera or an SD card. This one right here allows us to do things like review, batch rename, file info. We'll cover this stuff in a bit. This will open the image I have selected in Camera Raw. And of course, these right here will allow me to rotate the image if that's something I want to do. Over here, we have workspaces. And workspaces are just different ways to view the interface. And we can go into film strip, metadata, keywords. We'll make our own a little bit later, but those are our workspaces. And of course, you have an area over here to basically search for something. Now, if we come down here and click this button, we can decide what type of thumbnails we're looking at. Most images, not all, have an embedded thumbnail, which would be much faster than using the cache. It's up to you. You can say high quality on demand. In other words, don't create the image until I open the image up or click and select it. Or you can say always, which is what I do. You can say generate 100% previews, which is 100% the size of the image. Over here, we can do things like rate. My images are all 5-star. And we can say show them. So we can actually clear and filter and rate. We can sort by file name. Over here, we can see the last images that we have worked on, no matter where they are. Here, we can create a new folder, and here we can get rid of something if we don't want it anymore. Over here, we have favorites and folders. Filters, I love collections. Over here is the preview. We already looked at that. We can add keywords, and we can look at, check, or add metadata. Down here, we can change the size of the thumbnails. I like them a little bit bigger. Over here, if I click this button, it locks them into a grid. go back to this one. Or I can click here, or I can click here to have different ways to view the images. Let's go back to the default right here. In a nutshell, there you are. Everything about the interface. Now we're going to start talking about how we use it, how we organize with it, how we do a lot of things like keywords, etc., and then how we use it to make a bridge, if you will, from Bridge to Photoshop.